Hi there, I'm Alex Berg, and I'm joined by Dave from Feedback Gaming, and we're playing Crusader Kings. No, we're not playing Crusader Kings. Where the hell did that come from? We're playing Hearts of Iron 4. Yeah, right. Say hi,
Hearts
Dave.
Hearts of Crusader 4.
Hearts of Crusader 4. Yes, we converted a game from Crusader Kings to, yeah, that would be something, wouldn't it?
It's a mod for Crusader Kings. You think that's what it is?
This is a mod for Crusader Kings 2, yes.
We're building those relationships of our leaders. That's what we're doing.
One hell of a mod.
Get the best traits.
Okay, come on. Come on. Breakthrough.
I think I pretty much summed up what I was doing. Are you just concentrating on your Eastern Front? Is that what you're doing?
Yep.
Cool. Ooh, the Baltics are all together, aren't they?
Yeah, because Russia prioritized war with me, so the Baltics never fell.
Those fools.
I could guarantee.
Oh, them. They're still suffering from officers purged.
Yes, they are.
Another year, another 14 months of officers purged. Oh, damn.
Damn, son.
Wow. Okay. All right. I'm gonna join you.
Holy shit, there are a lot of divisions in front of you, too.
Hmm. Oh, damn.
They're probably crap, though. Romania joined the Allies. Right. Of course they did. Why wouldn't they?
Oh, boy.
Okay, I'm gonna have to pull you guys off the line. And then you're gonna have to go and deal with that noise. That particular brand of noise, which is the sound of Bulgarians getting their face beaten to a pulp.
Ah, this event, the Indian National Army. Yeah, we'll do it. Why not? I don't really want it, though.
Oh yeah, you're forcing the, the English AI to guarantee independence.
Yeah, we'll do it. Why not?
Actually, Romania joining the Allies is a lot better than Romania joining the Russians, that's for sure.
Yes, definitely. And bonuses, you're going to get 70 oil as well, so damn.
Yep. Where are my panzers at? Come on. Come on, panzers.
You got some awesome, shiny Japanese tanks as well. The YOLOs are the best variety of tank.
Oh, I have the YOLOs now?
Yes.
Thank God.
They're a shiny, very shiny light tank. Alright, there's... Oh yeah, we're not at war with the Dutch, are we?
You can trade with them.
Yeah, I know, but I don't really mean to be honest with you. One, two...
Unless you find that offensive?
I don't know. I guess right now... Alright, I am going to attack the Soviet Union, but I'm just reorganizing my troops on the front, because I'm going to have such a big front. Yours is quite narrow, but mine is going to be huge. I have to push through Mongolia as well. And that is a nightmare to push through because the infrastructure is bad. Really bad.
Oh, look, the English show up.
The English are coming.
Bloody. Oh, shit. That is horrible. That is absolutely horrible. What are you doing?
Are you encircling yourself?
Yes. That's a lot of divisions, too.
Amphibious assaults. Go. OK, Okay, let's do a risky strategy. Let's just grab one division and do an amphibious assault. 7 days, yes. I'm tempted to do an amphibious assault into India as well. Maybe I should take Ceylon. Yeah, I might do that, you know. That's a good idea, actually. I don't know why I didn't do that before. That's a good idea. I am the champion of good ideas. Okay, and we have to maneuver my navy around. So Big Fleet 1 is here. Big Fleet 2 is here. Oh, they're defending the coastline. I need those there. And Big Fleet 2 is defending the Pacific, which I don't need to defend, so I don't need them there. Yeah, Big Fleet 1. Go here and here and here. Good. So one thing I have noticed about veteran difficulty is you notice that you don't have nowhere near enough political power, do you? Because I've at this stage in the game, I've literally got all my research and production done and nearly all my military staff. Mm-hmm. At the moment, I would say just under half done at the moment.
Yeah, that is a bit of a problem.
I actually kind of prefer it, you know, because it makes you feel like you get that done all out of the way, like, a little bit too quickly. Like, at least now it feels like you're kind of still working on it as you're progressing in the game. It makes you, like, prioritize different things that you need the most.
Agreed.
You know what? I don't want to mean to put any fear into you, but that Switzerland is scaring me.
Switzerland?
Yes, they do. Don't they just randomly declare war out of the blue sometimes?
Yeah, they do, but...
I'm nervous for you.
Right now I have bigger fish to fry.
Yeah, you have. You've got a lot of fish to fry. You're fishing the whole ocean.
Yep. Another 3 days, come on. May the 9th. May the 9th, baby! We have to rescue these. There are 30 divisions in there.
Okay, we are now attacking with one Marine division. Wish him luck.
Well, good luck.
You'll need it. You know what? This has actually convinced me to play on slower speed, you know. I'm a bit aggressive. I'm like 90% of my games at 4 or 5 speed. And I feel like I feel the urge now to play a bit slower, because you can get more done, can't you?
Yep. Got my divisions back.
Hey. Ooh, who are we attacking here? Oh. Australian convoys. We have got a pocket in Burma. The Burmese pocket.
The Burmese pocket. That sounds like a movie.
Burma's a war zone. Can we land? I think we're gonna land. Yeah. One day, 1 hour, 23 hours. Oh, what? Siam! Siam's grabbed Singapore. Siam, can you give me that land, please? Thank you.
Siam, please.
Yeah, I know, it's so frustrating. Oh, they're a puppet, so they'll always say yes to my request, won't they?
Yep. They will.
Oh, actually, they're my puppets, so I'll get the oil rubber anyway, won't I?
Oh, yeah, you can just tell them to give it to you.
Yeah, okay, never mind. That's pretty pointless. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, I'm going to rely on the stupidity of the AI to not have troops
back
on
that,
their ports.
That old trick again?
Yes, that old chestnut. I'm relying on the stupidity of my enemies to overcome them.
So how are things going in Russia for you?
They're not. I have not attacked yet. I'm still moving troops into position.
Oh, goody.
I'm glad you've told me that's reminded me as well. Oh. Bum, bum, bum. Music's too good. Okay, how are we doing for supplies? My artillery's behind. Ooh. We're not making much production here because we're focusing on roads.
Roads, an island in the Mediterranean.
That's right, yes, yes. Them roads, too strong. Please nerf Paradox, nerf the roads.
Oh yeah, but yeah, too strong, sure.
Give me Singapore. They refused? Get out, come on.
What you do in Singapore?
Oh my god, that's so annoying. Oh god, the rustling. Doesn't matter. I'm just gonna get all the rubber from you. Give me all your rubber, dude. I'm gonna take your rubber whether I need it or not. Oh, I don't even need it. I mean, I think for some reason I have got Singapore, but the color hasn't changed.
Yeah, it takes a while for it to update.
Yeah. Any other land that I need? No. Nope. So, I'm producing a lot of tanks, but I'm not actually using them.
Well, feel free to send them to me.
Yeah, I don't know. I was planning to make a big stockpile of them and make a division, but I'm not really doing that at the moment. All right, guy, I'm sorry, but some of the things on the Lend-Lease are going to have to be adjusted because I'm struggling. I'm really sorry, but I am going to have to end the... equipment, I'm afraid.
Fair enough.
Oh, I shouldn't be doing that. Oh, okay, I know what I'm doing wrong. I'm making too many MPs, that's the reason why. The Indian front is won. I don't need to even focus that anymore.
Hell is going
nice
on in Africa.
Division pocket. Ooh, my invasion of Sri Lanka is underway.
Cool. Still waiting for you to say my invasion of the Soviet Union is underway, but.
Hey, I am preoccupied right now. I'm juggling many balls. You have two balls. You've got the UK and you've got USSR. I've got very many balls, okay?
You have teeny tiny balls. I have huge balls.
You should see my balls. They're huge.
They're gargantuan, really. They're... It's amazing. I can even walk straight. Such balls you've never seen before.
Yeah. Okay. I gotta admit, actually, you have got Romania as kind of your kind of little ball front, haven't you? As well, I'll give you that.
Tiny ball front. Come on.
Okay, supply shoes in Bangladesh. Man, the difference between 2 and 3 speed is actually quite big, isn't it?
Yep, it is.
An amphibious landing on mainland Japan. Okay, I don't really even want to risk that even happening, so... Let's make sure that's covered. Okay, I really want to make destroyers now as well. Destroyers, new submarines. Ooh. Okay, so this province is not relevant anymore. This one's not relevant anymore. This one's the Siberian front.
Siberian Burma. Front. Sounds promising.
Burma.
I'm using my Panzer Army to go through the mountains. That's some stra- that there's some sort of military genius right there.
It's like what's his face, isn't it? Going
Hannibal.
Through the yes, that's right, Hannibal through the Alps with the elephants.
Yep, you can call me Hannibal.
I will, from now on, you're no longer Alex. You are Hannibal. Okay, that's good. We're only a little bit behind on oil now. Man, we've managed to balance the boat.
Well, that's good, I assume.
Yeah, at least we're actually meeting our quotas. Nice.
It's very nice.
Okay, so maybe we should focus on
here or here.
Oh my god, that little island just frustrates me. We have to get that little island. Oh, there's like so many islands that the UK's got, like little tiny ones that need to be...
Tiny island is tiny and annoying.
Yes, very annoying. Alright, let's grab a few of them. That'll suppress my OCD. Yeah. Oh, do an amphibious landing on Sri Lanka. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to send you some more tanks. I am not using them, and at the moment is I am probably going to make a tank division at some point, but right now I'm not. So you can have pretty much 85% of my production of tanks.
Good. Do I have enough convoys to actually move this stuff to me?
Yes. Yeah, I made sure. Yep. Check how many convoys have you got in the number at the top?
853.
those are ones that aren't actually on duty.
Yeah.
There's ones
that doesn't say anything about the lend lease, so.
Yeah. Oh, it doesn't. It should come under trade. And
oh yeah, no, there it went down. It's probably under trade and supply, but now not just 789, so it's probably.
Yeah, you got loads. You got loads.
Tons, baby.
I need the new. Okay.
All right. So, I still not fully prepared for Russia yet. Oh god. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab all my extra divisions, the ones that are like auxiliary forces.
Mm-hmm.
I've got MP divisions here. They should be on here.
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna move all my auxiliaries into the Siberian front just to cover the whole. The biggest issue isn't that I haven't got enough firepower, it's the fact that I haven't got enough divisions to spread the front, that's the reason why.
Yep. Because you really should have units along the whole line.
Hey, okay, so what's happened now? So the Indian National Army, for great justice, two divisions of the Indian National Army arrive in Singapore, 10,000 manpower. National unit reduction for British Raj, -20%. Gains national spirit of Azad Hindi, which grants extra fascism for India, I'm assuming. Oh, I see. So people talk about that event quite a lot, because that's what frees India, isn't it?
Yeah, if you want to do the two achievements at once, then the New World Order and the One Empire at once,
yeah,
you pretty much have to get that thing to fire, because you have to get rid of British Raj as a puppet. Or turn them fascist. And England has no way of turning the Raj fascist on its own.
Mm.
Which is kind of weird.
Yeah, I think that needs to be in the game. Just the ability to remove a puppet. If you are the master, you have the ability to remove it.
Yeah, and I think a puppet should always have its master's ideology, or at least move towards it.
Yeah, that is kind of strange. But then again, it kind of makes sense, because I guess some democracies installed dictatorships in their puppets, didn't they?
Yeah, but this is the other way around.
Yeah, yeah.
Which makes it all the stranger.
I just don't really need that many divisions here. I'm going to take half on the way. So, I think this is really annoying. I'm hoping they'll fix this in the next patch, but why can't you draw a front line over nations, over multiple nations?
I have no idea.
I know, it's so infuriating, isn't it?
Yep, it's just, it seems really retarded.
Oh my god, it's so annoying. Okay. Yeah.
Somebody
just split them manually over and over and over again.
Metric ton of units.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. Convoys, supply. Oh, there's gonna be supply issues inside of Mongolia.
Yeah, you think?
Yeah, I know. I don't think I know. Constantly reminds me of the slow supplies icon.
No, don't do that. Don't stop it. Stop it. We are not attacking there. God damn it. The last thing you want to do is attack there. So everybody just chill out. Go do something else.
There's a lot of chromium. Africa, for the most part, is a pretty crappy continent when it comes down to, like, resources, isn't it? Aside from that chromium in the south.
A part of me thought there would be more. Me too.
I'm kind of disappointed that, because it doesn't give you much incentive as Italy to kind of hold Africa, does it?
Nope.
Yeah, I guess that does grind me a little bit, that.
hold on, I just need to... Oh, did I actually fix that invasion? I did. Okay, good. Yeah, well, they're not going to join anytime soon, so...
Jungles everywhere.
Chaos in the jungle.
I think I do overemphasize my infrastructure. I think when I see a supply issue, I go a little bit crazy. It's because the low supply indicator only reduces by something like 10% reduction. It's not that much. But then the big one reduces by something like 60%.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have a tendency to go all panicky when I get the low supply thing too.
Yeah, they're like, they've got a little dirt path, and suddenly I've just built a four-lane highway.
Seems reasonable.
I'm not overreacting, okay?
I'm not so much solving supply problems as overwhelming them. Which was the British way of describing America and logistics.
Really?
Yeah, they don't so much solve the problem as overwhelm it.
Interesting.
It's a cool way of describing it, methinks.
Yeah, we couldn't get this island.
I don't wanna spend too much time microing in the east, getting these little islands.
What are these islands you're talking about?
They're all the ones in like the Indian Ocean, like Seychelles, and then looking at Madagascar as well, maybe. If I invade South Africa to get that chromium, I'm still going to have to designate forces there for a long period of time, so I want to tie myself down, so I don't really want to do that.
Fair enough. Oh, come on, Romania, give up already.
Pulled out a lot of troops on my Indian front as well. Oh, I'm trying to think if that's the right decision.
Oh, I actually have a pocket of Russian troops. 7 divisions. Woohoo!
Damn.
Well, it's the first time it's happened.
27 divisions, really?
I think I'm putting too many troops on one front.
Oh, and Zhukov is in charge. How nice. Hello, Zhukov.
Zhukov, is that your general?
No, that's one of the most famous Russian generals of all time.
Oh, really?
Marshal Zhukov. Yeah, he's the guy behind the Kursk offensive and the Stalingrad defeat or victory, however you want to look at it.
Damn, that nice little encirclement. 6 divisions. Nice. And Romania's not... Oh, Romania's actually... Okay, I was just thinking to myself, I got the pink and the yellow mixed up.
Yeah, no, they're... they're more or less done for. Just have to sort of finish it.
So
and they're proving surprisingly resistant to change, let's put it that way.
Okay. I think we should end this episode with a bang.
Okay. Okay, yeah, it's time, isn't it? You or me?
This is the bang.
Oh, there's a bang!
There it is. Kick Woohoo! Bang.
Let's see how that works out. So many red numbers!
I think it was too soon.
No, it's okay, it's okay. It's just that they're not fully organized, I don't feel confident. But doing this puts me in the war, right? I can draw a front line, then we can slowly push them back. Slowly.
Okay, I'm waiting for one final thing here before we call it. There's really, really one out. Zig.
I think I'm just gonna... Yep. I don't have to focus on those roads anymore.
And somebody actually sunk some German transports in the English town. That's amazing.
No.
Yes.
Trying to focus on where to prioritize my road building. Yes.
Come on, Bucharest. You know you want to. Well, you probably don't want to, but you know you should. Give up the bloody ghost already. Less than a day, sure.
And
yes.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna stop pushing west now. I think it's time to turn on New Zealand and jump on Australia. Oh wow, Romania's gone.
Yes.
At long last.
Thank you. Still has some troops left on there, so maybe still.
We're just moving through.
Okay. Stop. Do that. You guys select all.
Oh boy.
Maybe.
It's gonna be a weird while to organize this front. It's such a big front. Working on the tanks now.
Okay, so you guys... What? You go there. Another Panzers. Okay, so that should probably do it. Just gonna clean up my fronts and then we can go, okay?
Cool. Support equipment is done. 1940. Oh. Artillery. We should do that. Artillery.
Mm-hmm. and the rest of the front is fairly static. And now that you've opened up the other one, let's see, how are you doing? Ah, you're doing okay.
I'm doing really good, thank you.
Couldn't be better.
Okay, I'm going to wait one more day, land on this island, Christmas Island, fully enough, and then I'm going to launch an assault on Australia. That's right. Cocoa Islands. 42 people on there.
All you need is rum.
And with a... Everyone, assault Australia. Here you go. Select all, maybe? Oh, there's too many divisions. 9.
There we go.
2 divisions? This is not a valid invasion route. I think it is.
I think you'll find it is.
There you go. Okay, there you go. I am
fully committed.
I am fully. Yeah, that's it. So next episode is going to be me invading Australia, and then maybe we stabilize our front in. I'll be honest with you right now. I am not actually making any gains in Siberia. None at all. I'm just literally just taking supplies off them, helping you out. That's all I'm doing.
Well, that's all we ask.
The three fronts are now open. Total war has begun. Any final words?
Yeah, I'm gonna just ask Hungary here for control of everything they got in that war.
Yeah, that's right.
So, Hungary. And yeah, they gave me most of it.
There's a joke there, right? Isn't there? Hungary, Hungary? No.
Hungary, Hungary, Hungary.
Yeah, that's right. Hungary, Hungary, Hungary for provinces.
Well, if you look at the East Front now, I think things are looking...
It's stable, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And now I have opened up a broader front, so supply issues might not be that much of a factor anymore. I'm going to start building up some infrastructure around these parts.
The strength of those divisions is pretty bad on the Russian side, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks like I think they've kind of spent themselves.
Yeah,
so
I
was focusing very much down south, but I think while I was busy invading Romania, they spent the rest of their strength.
They're not their best anymore. Their best has definitely ended.
Yep.
Guys, if you've enjoyed this, remember to like and subscribe. I've been with Alex. I forgot your surname, Alex.
Berg.
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 B-E-R-G.
Yep.
And I'm Dave, Feedback Gaming. Guys, I hope you all have a good day, and good night, and God bless.
Cheers.
Bye.